beats us to the punch.
Hey there, Bare Knuckle News fans. I am here with Ike Villanueva, the brand new heavyweight champion in BYB Extreme. Ike, congratulations. And can you break down the fight for us?
Oh, man. That was a good old Wild West shootout, Texas showdown, man. I knew I had to bring it. Thank you for DJ for taking me to war and really me showing what I have. I really have that, what we call it back home, puro chigón. I'm tough as nails. I don't back up. And it's puro raza where I come from. Blue collar Mexican, what they call me back in Texas. And man, he just brought out the Aztec war in me, and it was just beautiful. It was beautiful. Yeah.
It was a beautiful fight. Let's talk a little bit about how it went down, because it was kind of, I feel that he came out very aggressive in the first round, but then you kind of took the fight and made it your fight towards the end of the fight.
Yeah, I just reeled him in. I got some of the best counterpunching in the game. My counters are very fast. I learned it at an early age, and you follow my career, my check hook is one of the best. And you, then once that check hook started landing, that six came through, and that's what really caught him in that fourth round, and it cut him up pretty bad. And DJ's never been done up like that, and he turned, and he like ran from it. But, man, respect to him, because he's a warrior. He's a father like me, tough as nails. Hey, a message to y'all, young cats coming up. Put some respect on those old dogs. We can throw down, baby.
You sure can throw down. So how did you prepare specifically for him? Because he's a southpaw.
Oh, man. Just hard work, man. Coach Larry Crow, my day one training partner, with my coach in this, we went to work, really putting in the work. Larry's a great southpaw. We learned how, you know, stepping left, taking away his jab. Coach Jesse down at Main Street, man, they really put me to work, man. Coach Jesse handles all the amateurs. So I went back to train with those young guys and get that fire back. And Coach AJ, man, y'all know AJ. AJ's a legend. And I really brought him in as like that third, just that mentor, because he's been in the game so long. And I just hired the best. And we all came together and we put a puzzle. And it worked masterpiece. Hey, we're playing chess. We're not playing checkers.
You're not playing checkers, sure enough. Now, did DJ do anything tonight that surprised you in the fight?
Oh, nah. We knew he could take a punch. We knew he was tough as nails. My goal was to put him away before he put me away. And it was, that fourth round is like, who had bigger nuts? That's what it was. It turned, you got to put, it wouldn't, they wouldn't have respected if I beat DJ by decision. Yeah. To be the champ, you got to beat him. Yeah. And I put the champ away tonight. And it was beautiful. I think we got fight of the night. I don't know. But I hope we did. And because I hope he deserves something too. But it was great, man. But to put him away like that, and man, I'm speechless.
Now, you know, one of the things that I find interesting is that you are very proud of your Mexican heritage. So let's talk a little bit about that, please.
Just blue-collar Mexican mentality, man. I'm a father. I got four girls. I got two other boys. Me and my wife, we got a blended family. When I met my wife a while back, she had two, I had two. Then we brought two together. And I raise those kids like they're mine. I have four girls I love to death. My goal in this is show my kids hard work pays off. It don't matter what you do. You have a goal, put it in sight, put the hard work, it will pay off. And it paid off. Look at my son. My son right here is 6'4", 300 pounds, Jackson State O lineman. They doubted him, and now he's making me proud, and I'm still almost 40, making my son proud. But what a better way to have my son here ringside and watch his dad become a world champion. Not just any champion, a world champion. It was wonderful. And for the mentality back home in Houston, all the raza, you can't stop a hungry Mexican. You can't stop a man on fire. You can't. It's written in the books. You can't stop, man. All glory to God, and just thank you.
You're no stranger to titles, but how does it feel to be that winner tonight and win the belt for Bare Knuckle?
This is my third title, but this is a BYB is coming from MMA and coming from the UFC. They coming here and claiming a world title. It's wonderful. My buddy Austin Trout just won the BKFC title last week out of Main Street, and I'm bringing the BYB back to Main Street. So you got two world champions out of one boxing gym. It's kind of awesome. But just the feeling to be able to do it, and when all they always talk about, oh, MMA guys can't box, well, been there with me. And think about it, you're in the trigon. There ain't much room to move.
Right.
Man, it was just, God, did you hear the crowd?
I did hear the crowd. They were going crazy, well, that's for sure.
That's what fed the energy. That's what fed me. It's like you feed off the energy, and it was awesome, man. Biloxi, Mississippi, I'll be back whenever they want me. I love it here.
Let's talk talk about your journey a little bit as a street fighter, as a kid, coming full circle here, because Donna was very much part of the backyard brawl, the street fighting game. So talk to me a little bit about your journey in that.
It's just tough, man. You come up, man, like you come for nothing. You want to make, quiet mouths don't get fed. You want to make a name for yourself, you got to talk. You got to be real vocal, and that's me. But coming from the streets, coming back, from coming from fighting, it's just tough nose. You fight to the finish, and it's here. DJ was cut. Most fighters would have looked for the doctor stoppage. It would have been in the fighter's head, oh, they're going to stop it. Not this fight. They were going to let us bang it out. I cut him, he cut me, and who wanted it more? But that's what you learn from the streets. You learn the hard knocks. That's what it's about.
I know that your Mexican heritage we just discussed is very important to you, but I also wanted to ask you, I read somewhere that this fight was more important to you than money. It was a legacy fight for you. Talk to me about that, please.
Man, I lost my father in 2013, and my dad was, they wrote my dad off plenty of times, man. Like, but my dad proved it wrong, opened his own business. It ran for 20 years before he passed. And I found my dad did. I try to bring my dad back. And it's just like I carry a lot of pride and emotions because of my dad, because when they gave up on him, we didn't give up on my dad. My dad said, hey, I'm going to start a business. We moved to Lubbock, Texas, one bedroom house, just for my dad to chase his dream. And it was that's where family comes in. You rise together. You come up together. I had my sister, my brother here. Man, it was amazing. My brother told me before I came out, let your name be known, represent for dad tonight. And I did that, and it was just amazing. But like I said, it takes an opponent to bring the best out of you.
I agree. And
just thank you for DJ for bringing the best out of me, and it was amazing.
What a great story of courage and triumph, which really goes to prove, fight fans, that many people just look at the fighters in here and they think about the warrior spirit inside them, the fire that's burning inside them, and you certainly exhibited that tonight.
Yes, ma'am.
Really, really did.
Yes, ma'am.
Your brother Tommy was also a great influence on you. Let's talk a little bit about him, please.
Yeah, so my brother Tommy, man, so coming up, my dad worked nights, and man, having nights and, you know, being in the oil field, 24/7 shop, so my dad was always on call. My brother showed me how to play football, how to play basketball. He coached me up, showed me how to fight. He was just, my brother was, Ron was in the military, so it was Tommy home with me. He was my father figure, man, to this day. Like, and I'm very blessed to have a brother like that, because it don't matter how bad he can, like, poke the bear. I'm never going to poke back at the bear, because that's my father. He's like a father to me. But to have him here, to have him witness this,
yeah,
amazing, man. And I don't know if y'all saw my 13-year-old daughter. She was just crying because she goes, Dad, you did it again. When they said you couldn't do it, you did it again.
Speaking of your daughter, I know she wrestles. What are your thoughts about having her go into combat sports?
Oh, man, Haley, that's going to be the one. My daughter Haley, she's going to be the one. I promise her. It's crazy. Just this week, I got full custody of my daughter.
Wow, good for you.
15 years old. So I had a roller coaster this week dealing with it. But now I have all four of my girls in one household. As a father laying down, it's amazing. It's just amazing. Now I ain't got no stress no more. I have my baby home. And as a father, that's the greatest joy ever.
And you got the title? You're ready to go?
I'm ready to go.
You're ready to go, baby? Bring that title home?
Yes, ma'am. Hey, my baby Gianna, Gabby, Haley, Lexi, Daddy's coming home.
All right, before we go tonight, any friends, family, or sponsors you'd like to thank?
Oh, yeah, everybody, man. Primo Mix, GSI Global, man. Chilada Mix. Oh, man, Taqueria del Sol, man, represent. Primo Mix, man. Everybody, Jam Realty, everybody that's been behind me, Mr. Dr. Pruski. Mr. Pruski's been there since my UFC days and really getting me healthy. And he's here tonight, and it's just amazing, because guys and friends like that will come out here to support you, it motivates me. So, man, I'm very thankful. Everybody back home, thank you. Everybody back home, man, blue collar, it lives. Thank you.
So, mucho gusto para conocerte y gracias para la entrevista. I hope to see you back here soon, fighting in the Trigon. So for Bare Knuckle News, I'm Susan Cingari, and this is
Hurricane Ike Villanueva, the new champion.
And no one, I remember no one, come on, beats us to the punch.